Have y'all ever had any of your own haunted experiences, seen any ghosts?
Oh yeah. Yes. For sure. I think everybody has, like, had a experience or one or two experiences, and even if you don't, like, think ghosts are real or whatever, they're still, like, unexplainable. Like, you can't explain that whatever happened. I know mine is unexplainable.
Mine isn't either. Silly.
What happens?
So when I was 3 or 4, I woke up one morning looking for my Cookie Monster cassette tape because I was trying to jam some Sesame Street at like 8 a.m. And I go to my parents' room and they wake up and they start immediately sort of questioning me, and they were like, what did you do? It's okay. You don't have to lie to us. Just tell us the truth. And I was confused.
What are you doing?
Yeah, I was like, what are we talking about here? And I started like crying because I didn't understand what they were talking about. Well, it turns out at some point in the night, a full face of makeup was applied to me. And I didn't do it because I remembered this like very clearly, even though I was like 3 or 4. And they kind of...
That's scary. That is scary.
It was scary. And my dad told me, like, once I was an adult, because we've talked about it, like, since I've been grown. And my dad told me it was really weird because all of the makeup was put in, like, the right spot. So, like, blush was on your cheeks. The mascara was in the right spot. There was eyeliner.
Oh, and no 4-year-old could do that.
Yeah, and like, he was like, there was no way a 4-year-old did that. And it's extra creepy because this house that we lived in Needville was, an old man died there, which I didn't know because I was a kid. But my mom used to see like a figure going around the corners. My dad woke up one morning and actually pulled a gun on a shadowy figure in their doorway. Like, my mom was at work that night, and my dad thought someone was there to the point he pulled a gun on the figure, and there was no one there. And just like creepy stuff. Like, I had an imaginary friend, and my dad said, "Who is it?" And I said, "An old man."
You don't ever have imaginary friends. My kid's not allowed to have an imaginary friend.
Yeah, I was really glad to get out of that house. I'm still creeped out by it. I've actually driven by it as an adult.
And it's in Needville?
Yeah, it's in Needville.
So that's not too far from here, right?
No, it's not.
Because, like, mine, so my spooky story, and I guess this is kind of several spooky stories, I'll smash it into one. But my mom lived in Bel Air over in Maryland. And with a boyfriend at the time, and I was older. I was like 15, maybe 16. And disclaimer, my mom is a little bit crazy and likes to scare small children like really badly. So I do have to say this because it pertains to the story. So my whole life, she scared me and scared me and scared me. So as a teenager, I didn't get scared anymore. I was like, oh, you're just being silly, like whatever. Well, she kept telling us, oh, my boyfriend's house is haunted. My boyfriend's house is haunted. I'm like, Mom, your house is not haunted. Like, that's nothing. And she was like, I'll prove it to you. Come stay with us and I'll prove it. And I was like, okay, all right, whatever. So I went and stayed with my mom, and we watched scary movies and stuff and veg on the couch when we would hang out. And I remember her saying, okay, I'm going to test it. And I'm like, test what? Like, what are you doing?
There's a whole process.
There's a whole process. She had been like experimenting for a while, so she had it figured out. So she went and got a glass of water, and then she got an empty milk jug, and then she got a full milk jug. So I'm like, okay, crazy lady. So she puts them all on the table and she's like, just watch. And I'm like, okay. Well, then I'm like, okay, Mom likes to scare me. She starts saying, okay, if you're here with us, if you're in the room, I want you to knock over one of the milk jugs. Nothing happens. So I'm like, Mom, nothing's gonna happen. Like, you're being silly. And she's like, okay, let's try again. She's like, okay, if you're here with us, and if you'd like to talk to us, knock the lid off of one of the milk jugs. And it was, you know, those milk carton things, you push it on, you gotta push it all the way down for it to be on. And it was all the way on. And we waited for about 10 minutes, and all of a sudden one of the milk jug tops literally popped off to where it flew across the room. And I was like, okay, like maybe there was like gas left over in the gallon thing. And Mom was like, okay, let's try it again. We have one more because we had two milk jugs. And she's like, okay, you know, if you're still here, go ahead and knock something else off the table. And like literally right when she said it, the other lid flopped off. And I was like, okay, I'm done. I'm so done. Well, she had told us throughout the house had like Civil War era guns that belonged to her boyfriend's great grandfather. They were hung up in the kitchen, they were hung up in his bedroom, and then there, I think, was one, like a placard or like a shield or something, hung in the living room. Well, most of the activity happened like in the kitchen or like between the kitchen and the living room where the guns were hung on the wall. But in his bedroom, my mom would never sleep in there, like ever. She said that there was a man in the closet with a cowboy hat on, and it was just a silhouette, but she got like a feeling of dread when he would show up. So she had her room on the opposite end of the house with no Civil War anything, no old antiques, literally nothing. And she started seeing a small child shadow figure like run around the house. And she said when that one was around, she didn't get that like bad feeling, but that's what made her like start to test things and be like, okay, I'm gonna try this and see if something responds. And we really never like, we never did anything to like try to talk to them, but we definitely felt it. And like, if you were near any of like the living room and the kitchen, it was like a hostile feeling. It wasn't a very comforting feeling at all. So it made, maybe it wasn't a ghost, but it was some sort of negative energy.
Yeah, it felt like negative.
It was something. And I mean, watching those milk jugs, I mean, having the empty one and the full one, because I mean, that's where she got me, because both of them popped off. If one would have done it, I would have totally been like, okay, air, gas, whatever. But she had gotten it down to a science at that point. And again, my mom is very scary and likes to scare people. This could have all been a mean trick, but I, to this day, think that the house in Maryland is definitely haunted for sure.